So we're going to demonstrate what would happen if a patient was suspected of having a stroke due to a major artery blocked in the brain. The patient would have first been screened in the emergency department, and some preliminary images from a CT derived to show us where the presumed blockage is. Once enough of a suspicion exists that the blocked artery is causing the patient's symptoms, they're rushed into this operating room. This is called the Angiosuite. The patient is placed on that bed, and now a large team rapidly begins to work in a very well-rehearsed, well-choreographed ballet of stroke treatment therapy. All along you, along the walls of this room, you can see every possible device and catheter and wire that will require to gain access, even in the most tortuous and most challenging vascular pathways. Remember, blood vessels aren't always straight, so we have to have every single type of catheter and wire ready to go through these crooked pathways to get to the brain and restore blood flow. We're going to use the rotation of this C-arm to spin around the patient's head, acquiring X-ray images at multiple angles, effectively forming a 3D data set. The data would be fed to the computer, and based on that, we can explore where an area of leakage or an area of blockage would be, and then measure what are the devices we need to implant to repair that or to pull a clot back out. We'll be able to gain access to the patient's circulatory system using either a femoral artery access or a radial artery access. We'll then introduce our catheters inside the body, inside the arteries, and then the rest is done by watching navigation on these computer panels. Once we're inside the brain, we can navigate all of these complex arteries, find which one's blocked, and repair that site. Generally, these procedures can take somewhere between half an hour to many hours, depending on the complexity and the state of the disease. Once these are accomplished, all the catheters are taken out, and the patient is really left with just a small little needle prick that's the only incision that's made. So even for the most complex brain disorders, we can now accomplish almost near miraculous cures through the smallest of incisions, really taking minimally invasive brain surgery to the limits possible.